3D molding is a process that takes chocolate to create hollow forms. The sky's the limit. We're gonna take this sphere and turn it into something spectacular. I'm gonna be working with tempered chocolate. We're using white chocolate and the sphere mold. Your molds have to be completely polished properly. We want that chocolate to separate from that mold and have a shine. You will not have a shine if your mold isn't polished properly. So we wanna get that chocolate in this mold as fast as we can. And we're gonna fill that up 2/3. If it doesn't go in fast, it will set and we won't have time to turn that mold. We're gonna take the top of our mold, we're gonna line it up just like that. From this point, we're slowly gonna rotate the chocolate like this, evenly coating around the mold. Patience is key. I can feel that chocolate in there, that liquid at the bottom. You just wanna keep on continually to turn it slowly until you feel that chocolate set. I now wanna put that there and I wanna rest that for about a half an hour on the table. Then we can put it in the fridge. This has just come out of the fridge. There's your beautifully cast chocolate sphere. Now it's time we cut it and we need heat. So we have boiling water in here. You can let that just sit in there for a few minutes. We've dried it, we have no water on here. And you can apply a little bit of pressure. You don't want too much pressure. And we're just continuously turning that just to get it through. Allow this to drop into the mold. There we go. See how you have the buildup of the chocolate? Now you can just take your fingers and slowly just smooth that out just like that. So I've decided to make this cute little penguin. We can use modeling chocolate to create that. When you're creating something heavy like a nose that you want to stick onto that chocolate, you can use glucose as a glue or you can use water. What's so special about this, inside we've created a beautiful ice cream based dessert. Use your imagination, you can just go crazy and you can blow people's minds.